guys, and welcome back to another train simulator video. I'd like to give a shout out to Ferran and Peter, who are supporters of the channel. And today we're going to be continuing our journey with Trouble on the Tracks Part 2. Let's not waste any time. First stop today is Gillingham, Platform 3. So, as with Part 1, Part 2 is also a career mode scenario, so we will be scored. Obviously we didn't get scored that well in the previous part, but hopefully we can do a lot better in this one. So essentially we're continuing from that part where we left off. We did stop at Gillingham Sidings next to that 395, and now we're going back towards Gillingham. And then I assume we're gonna be... I think we're gonna be turning the train around and going towards, what is this? I'll be honest, I'm not too sure actually. We might be doing a shuttle service between Rainham and Gillingham, it looks like. We did get a message at the beginning, but unfortunately it went away quite quickly, so I couldn't read it in time, so maybe after this stop it'll tell us what we need to do in this part. Okay, there are a lot of people and things that need to be moved. You will make two trips. Oh, and the TSR is up at Rainham. The limit is 20 miles an hour. It's still raining quite a bit, so be careful to patch out. Alrighty. Okay, let's get going then. It didn't tell us to switch cabs, so I'm guessing... I'm pretty sure Rainham is towards this anyway, so... Oh, no, wait. Completely screwed up, I think. And I'm going to drive quality coin. Let's actually... change cabs. I did notice the miles to Rainham was increasing, so it made sense that we're going the wrong way. Yeah, it's coming down now. I don't think he told us to switch cabs, so I was a bit confused there. And we did lose a few coins for drive quality. But anyways, I'll be honest in saying that driving and accelerating a bit too fast shouldn't really be considered as bad driving quality in my opinion. I mean, sometimes in real life, oh, 100 miles speed limit, I believe. Or maybe it's just before rain actually. So. I mean, sometimes in real life, train drivers might drive and accelerate quite fast to make up some time, so... In my opinion, I don't think we should get penalised for drive quality if we're accelerating from a station quite quickly. Anyways, this is a train simulator, so we know how bad the scoring system is on this game. First station is Rainham, and then I believe we're going back towards Gillingham. back towards Rainham, and then back towards Gillingham. And it looks like we're going to be ending at the same point as we did at the end of part one. Looks like there's no timings for the stars, so as long as we don't get any drive quality points detections, then we should be okay. Now approaching Rainham. Mind the gap between the train and the platform and the slippery platforms. Oh yeah, there's a 20-mile-hour speed limit just for Rainham, damn it. I completely forgot about that. That is typical of me, not really paying attention much, but anyways. Anyways, we're approaching Rainham now, so I'll be honest, I don't think it matters too much if we speed through a TSR. It's not like that's even simulated properly in this game, so what we can do is change ends and get ready. So let's do that. So turn off the wipers, turn off the lights, switch ends. As we head back towards Gillingham. Okay, let's get going. I'm going to assume that TSR will continue when we come back towards Rainham, so we can remember for next time. Speed limit should hopefully go up very soon. There we go. once again. Safe to say that we're not going to be getting a positive score in this scenario. But that's okay. Gillingham, and once again we will change ends. And be ready to get back towards Rainham. Assume that 20 mile hour speed limit is like a mile before Rainham station, so I know there's like a sign on the side of the tracks which will tell us, but it's not very easy in this weather and in the game to tell if it's coming up pretty soon or not, so we'll go around 40 miles an hour. And as soon as we see it, we'll go down to 20. It's over there. Yeah, with our second green signal is so. Thank you. Not too sure what that double yellow means, but maybe that's the TSR signal. Yeah, we braked quite early there. Unfortunately. We are now approaching Rainham for the last time today. This is Rainham. And for the last time, I believe. Change ends. Actually, we might be changing ends one more time once we head to Gillingham, because we're going to Gillingham Carriage Reception, which I'm pretty sure is the same spot as we ended part one at. Trains ready to depart for these minor doors. Shane Gillingham. Stopping at Gillingham, not picking up any passengers, and I believe this is on that side. Yes, it is. So, for the last time, let's change ends. Waiting for the doors to close. Once again, we will park up right next to the 395. So there might be a part 3 for this scenario. I have seen people saying that there have been issues with part 3 of this scenario, so hopefully those issues are fixed and I will be able to update on the channel. If not, then this will be the last part, hopefully not. And part 2 is complete. Give it a thumbs up. But yeah, that was Trouble on the Tracks part 2. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, share with your friends, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.